Hola, este es un nuevo programa de El Mundo. Gracias por acompañarnos.
Hello and welcome to our show, El Mundo, The World. With us is Dr. Michael Lightman. And today we are going to talk about developing new software, revolutionary software, in terms of how can it help us develop the correct relations between people. Thank you very much, Dr. Lightman. Dr. Lightman, I'm with you. Norma, on our previous show, we talked about a program that we will be able to develop in order to measure or try and understand what is our nature. We can't measure it yet because we don't have the ability to really know, are we closer or more distant? But what will be the main function of such a program if we still don't have the ability to measure ourselves in relation to others? Dr. Lightman, it doesn't matter how precisely we measure ourselves or not. The main thing for us is to know what do we belong to, giving or reception, in favor or against, on part of the will to receive or in part of the will to bestow. For a person to examine himself and do such exercises, in which he'll see what does he belong to. And then, gradually, he will also have the ability to feel, is he coming closer to the force of giving the Creator, namely, or moving further away? And this is what we have to give a person, a kind of feeling, sensation, ability to make his inner world more tangible, his qualities to agree or disagree with them, and then through these different states that he goes through, is it good or not? Am I good or bad one way or another? For him to measure himself, to be able to see really who he is. All in all, it's a matter of education. We want for that person to be able to judge himself, to be his own advocate, to him to be familiar with himself, to be able to look at himself from the outside in. This is the main thing, to be able to see himself through neutral eyes. Norma, to see himself neutrally, obviously, naturally he has an egoistic inclination. Dr. Lightman, everyone has an egoistic inclination. Everyone are 100% egoist. Therefore, we have to bring a person to a state where he will know that he is an egoist. Because anyone you talk to on the street, they'll disagree. Me, I'm not an egoist. I think favorably about others. I want the benefit of the world. Everyone immediately defends themselves. Norma. Suppose we have reached the understanding that all of us, without any exception, are egoists. This is our nature. We were born with this inclination. What's the next step? What's the purpose of knowing it, correcting it? Dr. Lightman, first of all, the recognition of evil, the recognition that our ego, that our nature is entirely egoistic and that I'm thinking only to my own benefit. To the measure to which I'm familiar with that, I acknowledge it, I have to add another exercise to that of how much do I lose by thinking only about myself. Because it seems to us that we benefit as a result, and really, we're losing big time in everything. Totally. And this is what we have to show. This is the next stage of our exercises, to show how much we're losing by thinking only about ourselves. How much are we hiding from ourselves, receiving the good that comes to us through our connection, that comes through our big circle, so to say, our big society. And this is the next stage. So here we have to show the world as integral and nature, that it is integral, and were we to take each other into consideration how much problems and troubles and wars and whatnot we'd prevent, we'd live a completely different life. This is the other side. From another perspective, how can we overcome our evil nature nonetheless if we unravel it, man's nature is evil from the very start in such a way that no matter how we twist and turn our evil, we will not be able to get rid of it. It's like something sticks to me and I can't get rid of it. There's something inside of me and I can't get it out of myself. It's in my thoughts, in my heart, it's everywhere. I constantly catch myself that I'm an egoist. This is how I think all the time. This is how I treat everyone egoistically without exception, and how much I lose as a result. After I reach a state that, with the help of different exercises that we give people, that we're losing, then we call this process the recognition of evil. That our ego is actually not to our benefit, not in our favor, that by that I can succeed and gain and be greater than everyone and get rich. But really, that by it, or that it brings me to bad things, that it is what causes, imparts or causes me to feel bad. Now, the question is, to the measure to which I acknowledge this, at least to some extent, and I have such inclinations, already a kind of understanding and decisions, that I want to at least get rid of a certain amount of my evil, the question is, what do I do about it? And here, there are already exercises with the help of which we can distance ourselves from our evil and even come closer to the good. The good meaning what? That instead of exploiting others, to the contrary, I want to exploit them in the other direction for them to be well off. Or we can say that by that I exploit myself. But in that I have to show myself and others and everyone that the kind of behavior that we call altruistic behavior, that this behavior is good for everyone. And I bring myself and the entire world into the best possible state that for sure I will not be harmed and that the world will be well off. And exercises. This is already the fourth stage of our program. Software. And that's how we advance. Norma, there are many questions. One of them is, will it be measured? Will we measure this with the help of grades that will grade us and will allow us to move from one stage to the next, or how? Dr. Lightman, it's possible to do it even though that it's not precise, because we can't measure inner efforts. Suppose I didn't sleep at night, or I was aggravated, or to the contrary, I have a birthday. There are many reasons to be good or bad, think one way or another. Man is a new person each and every moment, and therefore we can't measure it in numbers. We can measure it, but it should be clear to everyone that it's only for the time being, in order to, you know for a person to be able to compete against himself. Norma, if so, what will be the parameters that will allow us to measure things that are immeasurable? How will a person know that he's advancing? Dr. Leitman, he'll know by going over all of these exercises, answering, giving answers, feeling how in his life he's starting to format himself in a new kind of behavior. Norma, if so, will there not be an element of competition in regard to others? An element of who gave better answers, who did things more correctly, precisely? Will we not measure ourselves in regard to others? Dr. Leitman, it is possible to do it, and surely it's preferable, because that really puts a person in competition with others, and this will help him advance. But like every time, I warn that these things can't be precisely measured. And they're not true, but they're only for the sake of a person's more active development and no more. Norma, if so, what you're saying then is active development. So a software of this kind, should it be implemented through a system of integral education in which a person can participate? That includes studying the laws of nature in order to better understand what are we talking about, the connection, interdependence. Should that be in parallel? Dr. Leitman, all in all, he becomes an expert in personal psychology. Who and what is he in regard to others? He also learns a bit about others, but it's hard for us to learn about others because no one knows the states that others are in. It's hidden from us. And therefore, the main thing is for us to be able to understand who and what we are, to better understand our nature and where are we, on what level, how to rise from one degree to the next, until we discover ourselves under the good force of nature, opposite the bad force, in between these two forces, reception and bestowal. And when we discover, and that we discover the upper spiritual world between these two forces. Norma, if so, this software is supposed to be a part of the educational system? Dr. Leighton, of course. I think that eventually, if we develop it, it will be the main thing in the educational system. It will accompany a person from his very initial acquaintance with us until the very end of his final correction. Norma, you talked about an element of competition. How will the element of envy work here? We know that it is the most powerful engine that exists between people. I can be like others. I want to be as good as others. It's a desire, I suppose, but not to say that I want to gain at the expense of others, but I want to give more to others. So to try and open myself up to others, to connect to others more. So how will this element of envy be used? Dr. Leitman, in a very powerful way. Very powerful. Because envy is a tremendous force in direction of good and direction of bad, and therefore we also have to have the element of competition here. Norma, the programmers asked, this program,
que permitan la conexión y la cercanía con los demás.
Should it send us reminders to think and to measure our connection, our proximity to others? Should we get reminders, messages? Dr. Leitman, I don't exactly understand what you mean by that, but we all the time need to take care of a person that's working with this program, how he answers, what is he being asked, so that he'll understand that we're talking about his inner development, how he examines, sees himself, how he becomes his own advocate or judge, and this is how he advances. Norma, it doesn't have to do with physical actions, because this is what people always think, that to do good to others or being positive is that I help them take their groceries home, or I help someone walk their dog or whatever. Or that I helped an old person cross the street. There are different examples that give a person that this idea that people have about what doing good to others is. Can you explain what that is? Dr. Leitman, to do what the other wants. To do what the other person needs. Maybe not precisely what he wants, but what he needs. This is an action to the benefit of others, or more precisely, to help that person if we don't know how to enter his life and deficiencies and everything, to help him at least advance toward the same goal that I'm headed toward, the recognition of evil and doing good to others, until we become included in the upper force, we rise above this world, above the boundary of life and death, and this is how we advance. Norma, a final thought? Dr. Leitman, we have to start doing it in practice for us to be able to start. When we'll start building this program, working with it, we'll start talking about it, better understanding it, also get into it, and that we won't forget it in between our shows. Norma. And on our other shows with the writers and everything too. Thank you very much for your time. Dr. Leitman, thank you very much, and happy that you're concerned with this. Thank you.